congrats to Indiana State tonight. Came away with an overtime win there. Proud of our kids coming back and putting the game in overtime, but we had too many costly fumbles that put us in that situation earlier in the game. And then obviously in overtime, the first play there, we had an opportunity to hand the ball off or throw it, and we didn't hand it off, so that's why we're where we are today. So that's it for today. I think we got our backs against the wall. Got to get a win next week, and talk to the kids about that. It's a place that we've won before, and we have nothing to lose.
It was a read option then, or on the first play of overtime?
Yeah, it's basically a not really technically a read option because of the fact that you don't have an option back, but it's based on coverage. And you have an opportunity there to hand it off or throw a slant route.
I mean, you've had success with that route, especially in the fourth quarter. So.
Yeah, we've had success. You know, we just made the wrong decision, you know, and unfortunately it's where we are today, you know, and hopefully we'll learn from that and won't do that again.
With Hunter struggling a little bit up until the fourth quarter, any thought of going for someone else?
No, I mean, you know, a couple times earlier in the game there when we were in long yardage situations, specifically the first half, we got a little bit of pressure at a couple of the tackle spots. And then on the one third down there, they got us on a corner blitz, got us protecting to the field and got us on a corner blitz there on to the boundary. So it was something that they hadn't really shown and done, and we didn't pick it up.
You said 5 wins should get you in, so you think if you win next week, you should
get in? Yeah, I mean, it's be a fourth-ranked team. Obviously, if you can beat four-ranked teams in number one conference, I think it merits an opportunity.
You think you have to win to be considered the winner?
Yeah, I think we got to win. You know, can't leave it up to something else.
What was the difference? I mean, I know you had the turnovers and stuff like that.
Well, I mean, I think the three fumbles, I mean, you know, we were moving the ball. How many times did we move the ball down there? We had the ball down there near the red zone or in the red zone, and we coughed the ball up. We had we lost three fumbles. And, you know, it's something we do all the time. We practice ball security, talk about it, talked about it before the game, and, you know, you got to take care of the football. The football is gold.
What do you have to do to get this team up? I mean, they're going to be...
Well, they're down, you know, and that's part of our job as coaches. But, you know, I did compliment them after the game, though, on their effort of getting back in the thing. You know, there was a period of time there late in the third or early fourth where they could have packed it in or not fought back and fought back and got the ball down there and got it tied up. And it's kind of a wild game. Never really felt like we were really out of control of the game. You know, it's just we had some costly things happen, specifically on offense, that, you know, shot ourselves in the foot.
Donald said this was the toughest loss of his career.
Who did?
Donald Alessio.
Yeah, I mean, it's obviously tough. You know, it's senior day. Sure, that has a lot of emotions to do with it. And, you know, we expected to win, you know, and we had a good week of practice, and kids worked hard and came out ready and just squandered some opportunities.
Eric, with a must-win now, obviously, do you change anything as far as intensity or anything in practice over the next week?
I don't think we'll necessarily change anything. I think we'll have to do a good job of just regrouping our team, getting them to bounce back, and realize that you know, this is a road trip, another business trip on the road, and hostile place to play, loud crowd, and you know, we're gonna have to go out and play like we're capable of. Don't beat yourself, you know. I mean, you can't lose three fumbles and really, I mean, honestly expect to win the game. And fortunately, we were able to come back, knot it up, and have a chance. And you know, we didn't get it done.
What do you
attribute the mental mistakes to, not just the fumbles, but some penalties that kind of
should. Well, I mean, we jumped off sides a couple of times there. They were giving us a hard count. You know, I think that's one probably thing that just comes to mind as far as a penalty before or after the whistle. I think we had a personal foul there late down in their red zone there when we kind of had a potential hold or got them in long yardage. But, it gets to be frustration a little bit. But our D-line jumps the football. You know, that's why they're so active and they're able to get the pressure that they get. But they got to watch the ball. And it's a pretty simple fundamental as far as when that ball goes, you go. Till then, you got cotton in your ears.
With all the formations they did offensively, was that something you expected? Have they done that all year?
Yeah, that's pretty much what they do. They like to, I don't know how many times they threw it, 42 times, I guess, here. And that's pretty much what they do. Probably ran a little bit more, made them more of an effort to run it, probably, than, they tried to run it 38 times, which is more than they have.
Were they going for the ball on the fumbles, or were they making
concerns? Honestly, I wasn't watching the ball carriers. I watch more of the structure of the defense and communicate that to the offensive coaches. I have to look at it on tape, see if it was poor ball security. I mean, all teams try to attack the football. That's why you do all your ball security drills during the course of the week. And that's something that they've done well all year. I think they were number two in the country in takeaways, and ended up being really the difference in the game.
Thanks, everybody.
All right, man.